Association, and Jeff Mead is actually the Europe editor for the Press Association and joins us from Brussels. Good morning to you both. Jeff, just give us the tax situation in Belgium. Is it really much better in Belgium than it is in France?
Well, we always think it's hideously repressive here, but yes, compared with France, it's pretty good. But your average Belgian worker is paying the best part of 50% in tax. But of course, you know,
there's a voice to catch us.
Which is 75% over €1 million of earnings. So it is very high, and any normal person, apart from a celebrity, wouldn't think at all about coming to Belgium to save tax. It's just
where
not
did the one that was close
go? 75 makes it very high. How is this going to well, you can see how people might sympathise with him, but you can also see how people might feel he's being a bit treacherous, really.
I think you've summarised it perfectly. I listened to the Belgian foreign minister, who used to be the Belgian finance minister for several years, this morning on a French radio station, who was at length to point out that Belgium hadn't done anything particular to attract these French tax exiles. And it's true that Gérard Depardieu enjoys a very... a big popularity normally in France, but he is the subject of quite a lot of criticism, certainly on Twitter, also in the French media. He's had a number of French ministers yesterday who've almost tripped over themselves one after the other to criticise him, and it was of course sparked off by the French Prime Minister himself, Jean-Marc Ayrault, saying that he was on wanting to flee to Belgium.
How many are going?
It's three of them together having a flyover.
but is it an exodus?
It is not. Bit hard to tell. Exodus. But when you have a prominent Frenchman like Gérard Depardieu,
at least two. There might be three.
Well-known. French actor, internationally known with his international career going, and you were quoting before France's richest man, Bernard Arnault, the CEO of LVMH, the luxury goods company. Of course, this looks very bad, and that's why you had a succession of French ministers, one of which, as one would expect, was a French culture minister, Aurélie Filippetti, saying she was shocked, and, quote, saying, French citizenship is an honour, but it includes rights and also duties, which include paying taxes in one's country, to take part in the national effort against the economic crisis, and get this, she says, that Monsieur Depardieu is... she's accusing him of deserting the battlefield in the war against the crisis. But of course, the opposition, which is imploding, they're trying to replace or find a legitimate
leader.
Yes, a new MP. They're saying that they're saddened by this, and they're saying that Mr. Nabadu is a victim of the government's fiscal onslaught. Expect much more commentary on this. In fact, a lot of debate and a lot of bad blood, as well as a lot of ink from my French colleagues.
Mr. Seal, you're a seal.
I'm not getting it. Hold on, where are they?
Jeff, how do Belgians feel about attracting the French? Are they crowing? Are they glad? I mean, we can talk about famous Belgians in a minute, but I mean, how do they feel about getting Depardieu?
Well, there aren't flags waving in the streets of Belgium, I don't think, because
of the splash around.
Any celebrity name it can attract. And remember, you were saying earlier it had been hoped that some of these people might flee to the UK. Let's be cynical about this. You notice if you look at the map that this little village of Nechin is a spit and a cough from the French border. I mean, Depardieu could be a Eurostar in nearby Lille and be in Paris.
I hope I've caught some of it. I've been whizzing around trying to find them.
Just very briefly talk about famous Belgians.
Have you got them now?
I've got some. Well, the trouble is, there's different groups doing different things.
And we've got some painters, you know.
The one in line with the spa is the most active one.
How many others are there that, in fact, Jeff?
Well, we're talking about Bradley Wiggins, of course, today. Don't forget that the one that Belgians always cite is Eddy Merckx, who was the 5-times winner of the Tour de France. That was back in the 70s, and that shows you how desperately the Belgians cling to their established names. Here's a great one. Adolphe Sax, you can guess, he invented the saxophone, and that really is his name.
Audrey Hepburn, they claim Audrey Hepburn is theirs.
Yeah, she was born in Brussels, and she had some...
I've seen more tails than I've seen, or back flippers, I should say.
Rooston.
Then I've seen it a long time.
There were a couple of pop stars, Plastic Bertrand, Georges Lemaitre, who invented the Big Bang Theory. I could go on, but you might get bored.
Actually, we've run out of time. I can't believe we've run out of time to talk about famous Belgians.
Brussels and Belgium is about to split up between a Flemish and a Wallons.
It's always been about to split up, if it's never
happened. Oh, I think it's closer than ever.
Benedict Pavio, Jeff Mead.
Well, certainly three of them in that little group.
Yeah, 5 minutes there's tonight. Some others that are just
Bradley
in.
Wiggins has another title to his name after last night. The Olympic gold medalist who became the first Brit to win the Tour de France this year secured almost a third of the public votes last night to win Sports Personality of the Year. While Bradley Wiggins told us his triumphs were just part of the victorious...
Whoa, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
It just shows that anybody can do it. You know, when I used to watch sport as a kid on the telly, you know, it was the likes of Michael Johnson that from America, and you know, we had people like Seven that did it, but the void was incredible. And now I think people can really associate it with a lot of our sportsmen and sportswomen, and shows that you know,
they're so close into the shore, and nobody else is looking.
Bradley Wiggins, well, we're joined on the line by Sue Mott, the sports writer and broadcaster. She was on the panel that decided the shortlist, and here in the studio, we're
if you were standing
in the
spa car park, you'd have a hell of a show.
Good morning to you both.
Morning.
Sue Mott, that was quite a shortlist. Were you?
There's nobody there.
Who was your favourite? Can you say?
I don't think I'm allowed to. I think I signed a document that may have signed my life away to the BBC, and we were strictly under rules. But as it's over. I will actually tell you that I had a huge soft spot for David Weir.
Right. I mean, looking down that shortlist, and everyone, all the chat in advance, really hard to work out who was going to...
It was impossible. And actually, when Bradley won it and was up there on stage last night playing guitar for a band in front of thousands of people singing Wigo, you thought, actually, he is the man of the people. I can see why everybody voted for him. But honestly... If any of those 12 had won, even someone like Nicola Adams.